Hello friends, welcome to CABPD tutorials. In this class, we are going to learn how to draw the cross section of circular sedimentation tank in AutoCAD in a very simple manner. This is the cross section of total dimension 17,500 by 3000 millimeters of thickness 200 mm. At the inside, there will be a pre-board of 500 mm and this arrangement will be provided with two pipes. One is for impluent, another one is for effluent of 200 mm diameter. Inside, in front of impluent as well as effluent, there will be a baffle slab of dimension 50 mm by 600 mm, which will be placed at a distance of 900 mm from the inside face of the sedimentation tank. Okay. For the treatment, there will be a scraper. Scraper will be provided with the blades at the bottom. And at the bottom, there will be a sludge tank of dimension 1000 by 2000 mm, which will be pitted with the sludge removal pipe. Okay. Now let's start the drawing. Now let's go to AutoCAD. At first, select units, UN, enter. Select decimal, 0.00 precision and millimeter as the units. Click OK. Now select the rectangle command. Click here. D enter. And provide the dimension of 17,500 by 3000. Okay. Click. Now select this rectangle. And take the offset command. Provide an offset of 200 mm. And click it outside. Now select these two rectangles and explode it by pressing X enter. Now select the bottom two lines and delete it. Now I am going to draw the further things with the help of the construction lines, and in order to show the difference between the normal line and the construction lines, I am going to make use of different color for the construction lines. Now go to the properties panel in the home ribbon and go to the color here and select the different color, whichever you want. Now go to the command window and type XL for construction line and press enter. Here you are going to get different options like horizontal, vertical, angle, bisect and offset. Now I am going to select horizontal. Go to the second line and click here. Now cancel and select the same command, and now select the vertical option. Go to the midpoint. Okay, now click on vertical line, press escape. Now select the horizontal line and take the offset command. Provide an offset of 500 mm for pre-board and click it below. Again select that line and provide an offset of 3150. Okay, again select that line and drag the cursor below. Provide an offset of 1000. Press enter. Now select this vertical line and provide an offset of 1000 to the left. Again select the center line and provide an offset of 1000 to the right. Press escape. Now go to the properties and select the bilayer. Now select the polyline option. Please remember, it's not a line, it's a polyline. Select the polyline option. Now click on this line and click on this first intersection point and drag the cursor below. Click at this perpendicular point and intersection point, and now draw a horizontal line up to the midpoint. Press escape. Now select this polyline and take the offset command. Provide an offset of 200 mm and click it below. Now select these two polylines and explode it by pressing X enter. Here there is a gap. In order to complete that one, we can make use of extend command and the trim command in order to trim the additional portions, or we can take chamfer command here. Go to the modify panel and select chamfer command and click on these two lines, first line and the second line. You will get it a perfect join. Okay. Now, let us concentrate on the scraper portion, this portion. Okay, for that I am going to take the extend command first, ex, double enter, and extend the second line, second top line here, extend it. Now press escape. It is extended up to the center. Now select this line and take the offset command, provide an offset of 200 mm and press enter and click it above. Again select this vertical line and click inside, press escape. Now select the trim command, right click. Now trim up this horizontally extended portion, press escape. Now select this vertical line and delete it. Okay, now select this line. Now take the mirror command and click at this point and drag the cursor horizontally towards left or right. Click it and press enter. Now let us concentrate on the blades of the scraper. For that take the line option and click here. Now by holding the shift button, right click, select a perpendicular option. You will get a perpendicular point. Click, press escape. Now select this line, take the offset command, provide an offset of 200 mm and click to the right. Now press escape, take the line command and draw one line from ear to ear. Press escape. Now go to the edge command. Now select the solid pattern, click here, close it. Now select this blades of the scraper by window selection and go to the array option, select path array and click on this line. Okay, you will get several blades. Now we don't know what should be the spacing between them. So for that, what I'm going to do means this is the first grip point for source. This is the second grip point for spacing. I am going to select the spacing grip and I will move it along the path. I will make sure that only four blades will be provided. Okay, four blades are there. Click it. Now close it. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 are there. So I am going to select this blade and explode it first. X enter. I am going to select this additional blade or unwanted blade and I am going to delete that one. Okay. Next, we need these lines. For that, I am going to take the line option and keep the ortho on and draw one line here from the midpoint. Draw one line. Again, cancel and select. Draw one line. Cancel and select. Draw one line. Okay, now turn up the ortho mode. Now press space bar to repeat the same line command and draw a line from ear to ear. Again draw a line from ear to ear. Again draw a line from ear to ear. Okay, now press escape. Now take the trim command, TR, double enter, trim off these unwanted lines. Now let us draw the sludge chamber. Now okay, here we need to draw this sludge chamber. Okay, I'm going to delete all these reference lines. Now change the color, go to the command window, type XL for construction lines. Now select horizontal, go to the end point here and click one horizontal line, press escape. Now select this horizontal line, take the offset command and provide an offset of 600 mm, click here. Okay, now again go to the construction line, XL, enter. Now draw a vertical line where at the midpoint. Okay, click here. Now press escape. Now select this vertical line and take an offset command, provide an offset of 100 mm to the left, as well as again select this center line and provide an offset of 300 mm to the left only. Okay, now press escape. Now change the color to the bilayer. Now select the line command and draw a line from here to this point. Now press escape. Now what I'm going to do means delete these construction lines. Okay, now take the trim option, double enter. Now trim off this unwanted line. Now let us concentrate on the inplane and bevel slab here. For that I am going to change the color first, type XL for construction line, then type horizontal, click on the second line here. Okay, now select that second line and take the offset command, provide an offset of 500 mm, click it below. Now take the construction line once again, select offset option now and provide an offset of 900. Now select the second line and click this side, press escape. I am going to change the property to bilayer, select rectangle option and click here, D enter and provide the dimension of around 1500, okay, by 200 mm. Click it. Now select this rectangle and explode it by pressing X enter. Now select these two lines and delete it. Now in the home ribbon under the draw panel there will be a spline pit option. Select that one, turn off the ortho mode and go to the end point and draw one curved line here. Okay, spline. Once you get that one, drag it and press enter. Now select this, click on the copy command. Okay, turn on the ortho mode, select this point as the base point and paste it here. Press escape. Now select this pipe by window selection, click on the move command and click at the midpoint and move it here. Okay, now take the another rectangle option here, where rectangle, and go to the intersection point here and D enter, provide a dimension of 50 mm width and 600 mm depth. Okay, click, take the line command and draw one line from this intersection point to here. Okay, press escape. Now select this construction line and delete it. Now select these two lines also, delete it. Now select this line and change the line property to dashed line with sufficient gaps in between the lines. Okay, now take the trim command, TR double enter, and trim off these unwanted lines inside the pipe. Okay, now what we left out with here, we need to draw two lines from the center. It's up the width 200 mm. Okay, for that let us take construction line first, change the color. Now take the construction line, XL enter, click vertical and take the vertical line at the center point, press escape. Now select this line and take the offset command, provide an offset of 100 mm and click to the left, select the center line and click to the right, press escape. Now select the, now change the color, select the line option and draw a line from this intersection point to where, up to here. Again press space bar to repeat the same command, select this intersection line and draw a line up to here, where, up to the second intersection point, press escape. Now take the trim command, TR, double enter, trim up this line. Okay, we got everything. Now select these construction lines and delete it. Now by window selection, carefully select this much of portion, half of the portion, and click on the mirror command and go to the end point of this line and drag the cursor vertically, click and press enter. Now take the line command. Now click at this sludge pipe and draw one line here of some certain length, no need to worry about, and provide a vertical depth of 200 mm. Again drag it horizontally backwards and track this end point, click and join it, press escape. Now select this line and delete it. Now I'm going to select this curved line, click copy, click at this point, turn off the ortho mode and paste it here. Okay, now take the trim command, double enter. Now trim up these unwanted lines inside the pipe. Now we got the cross section of circular sedimentation tank. Remaining part will be dimension as well as labeling. And one more thing, please check the comment section below this video to get the drawing file which I used in this video. And moreover, thanks for watching.